This is Jordan Tao with JT News. Make sure you smash that like button, smash that subscribe button. Well, we got Keefe D. Now, he's reportedly shook in prison. A resurfaced interview says that he was scared to go back to prison. He was afraid of jail. But yet, you didn't act like that. You gave people so much information in your interviews that it was like, dude, You were begging to go back to jail at that point. You're like, yeah, I was in the car, I handed him the gun. You know, you did a whole, you wrote a whole book about it. Like, you might as well have just gone and said, yo, just arrest me, bro. Like, I did everything, you know, because it's like, they arrested him. Finally, he probably thought, like, man, if they didn't arrest me yet, they don't got enough evidence, I'm good. Or he got some type of, and you know, like, clearance to talk in LA, but not in Vegas, you know? What's weird is why they want to solve this crime all of a sudden, you know? You got to think about it. It's been like 26, 27 years, you know? Why now do you want to solve it? You know, everyone pretty much knew what happened. Vlad knew what questions to ask. I'm sure the streets knew when certain people got arrested and, you know, said certain things, you know. I'm sure a lot of roads led back to Keefe D, but yet they didn't, for some reason, they didn't investigate it. Something deeper is going on here now, you know. Suge Knight refuses to speak about anything, you know. I love how this is just going to be a mystery for the rest of our lives still. I'm sure there's way more to this than we know, okay? I'm sure there's links to, like, you know, certain music executives we know, you know, like, you know, that he has said that Diddy was involved, but that's yet to be proven, right? Because the guy that could prove it is dead, Zip, Von Zip, so... This is always going to be a mystery. You know, this will be some type of closure, but why? Why are they doing this right now? That's the real, I always wonder a deeper reason. So Michael Jordan recently sold part of his team, right? And now he's worth what? Like, he's one of the 400 richest people in America. He has like $3 billion. To be in the top 400 is crazy. I mean, there's, you know, billions of, you know, I mean, I'm sorry, there's millions of people, you know, among millions to be the top 400 is crazy. I mean, what do you rank in the world? It's pretty high, you know, there's so many people. So he's worth $3 billion now. And he's estimated to be just worth more and more as time goes on. Obviously, they're still selling Jordans, and you know, he'll still make different business teams. So he sold this team to Gabe Polkin and Rick Schnall in June that pushed him to crack Forbes top 400. I thought J. Cole had to own part of it too. So just a few months ago, Michael Jordan, majority stake owner of the Charlotte Hornets NBA franchise. In fact, he was in the organization for 13 years. Even though he has been heavily criticized for the Hornets' rosters and draft picks, his heirs still managed to increase the team's worth. He purchased them for $275 million and flipped them for $3 billion. Flipped it for a whopping $3 billion. After he sold the team to Gabe and Rick, that would push him to crack the Forbes top 400 list. His net worth is $3 billion as well. I thought, so what is double? I mean, he already had billions, right? 379th richest person in the United States. This, of course, makes him the most affluent athlete of all time and a part of the hardest honor. It says to reach the top 100, your net earnings need to be around $9 billion. We are sure he can eclipse this as well. Maybe. I think he's worth more than that, though. Michael Jordan, net worth. What do they say he's worth? I don't know, man. You know, you never know with this stuff. They say $3.5 billion. Who knows? Oh, yeah, his wife took a lot of money, too. How much did Michael Jordan's wife get in divorce? $168 million. Okay, that's not. I thought she had gotten $200 million. As Novena's worth is estimated to be $200 million, while Jordan has $2 billion. That was obviously old. 44-year-old Yvette Perkiel, first wife. Okay, so Cuban Ringer finalized his divorce from his first wife. I wonder if he's gonna have another divorce. I don't know why these guys keep getting married. If I got divorced once, I'm like, nah, I'm good, bro. Like, you already lost all that money. Let's see, spouse. Even so, these two have been together since 2013. She's hot. Yeah, she's good looking. All right, well, let's see. Dan, we got. Sorry about that. Sorry about taking so long on that. We got Natalie Nunn. She refuses to add Christian Rock to her live. She says, I'm good. She doesn't want the drama.
I'm not adding Rock to my live. I'm sorry. I'd rather not. I'm going to have a good, happy Money Monday, sweetie. I'm going to go to lunch with my girl. Add you to my live. Because that would be clout chasing. And that would be me adding you because you have more followers than me.
Oh. Yeah, I don't know. Also, I think Christian Rock details that her and her sister, Tanaka, whatever her name is, are still beefing after a jumping incident. Suki Hana dreamed to work with Drake. Isn't it everyone's dream to work with Drake? If Drake gets on your track, you're out of here. It takes you to another level. You're doing better than you were before. Then you got Lance Un-Rivera and Charlie Baltimore. Charlie Baltimore says, hey, when Un got stabbed, he claimed Jay-Z did it. But now he doesn't claim he did it. And she's like, well, I don't think he really did it. You know, because she's trying to still remain so real. But, you know, let's be honest. Jay-Z probably had one of his dudes do it, you know, like, because he supposedly leaked his album, right? And he was stressed. Volume 3, which wasn't even a really great Jay-Z album. I'm going to be honest with you. Volume 3 was like, it was nothing compared to Volume 2, okay? Volume 3 was cool, but, you know, first week sales were a lot back then. Like, you sold a lot of units. People had to go to the store. There was LimeWire and stuff like that, but people still got the physicals. Anyways, this is Jordan Tao with JT News. There's not a lot of news going on, but we'll get to some more news shortly. Peace.